Welcome. I see some late arrivals, but I suggest to give it a start. Shortly past 10. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Rotterdam, if you're not from Rotterdam. My name is Adri Meijdam. I work as Executive Director for the Bachelor Program International Business Administration. This is the first plenary session on the English Language Bachelor Program International Business Administration. So check if you are at the right program. Let's go. Welcome in the city of business, because there's quite some business around here in Rotterdam, not only by education, but also true business. You may have already noticed that headquarters of Shell and Unilever are next door. I'm curious. I mean, the large majority of you will be Dutch from the neighborhoods of Rotterdam, but do we also have some visitors from abroad today? Can I see some hands? That's nice. A quick yell, where are you from?
Ukraine.
Ukraine, quite far away. Other countries? Just scream. Yeah, okay. Well, this is typically IBA. We are running a highly international program, and we do have a very large diversity of students in the house. I'll show you later on. Especially for the ones coming from abroad, why would you choose the Netherlands for studies? Well, I'll give you a couple of reasons. On average, teaching quality, educational quality is pretty high in the Netherlands. All the universities we have do have a solid place within the first top 200 schools worldwide in the rankings. We're pretty good at talking English, not only at university or in the companies, but also in the streets. You can easily survive the Netherlands without talking Dutch. We've also chosen to go international at a very early moment. We've said we're a small country, there's a lot of other countries surrounding us, let's go international. And actually what you probably do not know is that the Netherlands is the largest provider of higher education courses in English, apart from the native speaker countries, of course, the US and the UK. So the Netherlands is a big player. We also think we're a pretty affordable country. We're working with relatively moderate tuition fees because most of the universities are public universities. So it's affordable fees. And most will also know, well, for instance, when you check the Lonely Planet or read other guides, we are a pretty easygoing country, relaxed, liberal, tolerant. It's nice being a student over here. So these are just some reasons to come to the Netherlands. Let's zoom in then on us. On Rotterdam School of Management, formerly known as Faculteit Bedrijfskunde in Dutch, but as said, we've chosen to go international already at a very early stage. They know us out there. Rotterdam School of Management is what they call a brand in the educational market. Employers know us, students know us, parents know us. Why is that? Well, actually, there's thousands of business schools worldwide that you could go to, where you could apply for. So the question is, how to pick out a good business school? Well, there's a few indicators for that. One, very important, is a business school internationally accredited? And accreditation means that a professional external organization is putting a stamp, a seal of quality in your school. For business schools that have international ambitions, only three really matter. First, ASCSB, which is American. And then we have its European counterpart, which is EQUIS. And there's also the British one, AMBA. I hear a phone ringing. I forgot to say, please switch off your cell phones before we start, so please do so now. Which also, when we have the latest arrivals, gives me the chance to not only welcome you here in the lecture hall, but also the ones watching us. We have live streaming of the session, so we have a large audience out there all over the world. Welcome. Great that you are with us also, be it on distance. Try to be with us next time, but welcome. As said, accreditations, very important for business schools. And any business school, at least having one of these international accreditations, you can be certain that's a good school. So check. Second, are you in the rankings? There's many of them. Wall Street Journal, Business Week, Neue Carrière, Dutch rankings. We think the most important is the Financial Times one. Well, regardless how all these rankings measures, we're always in. So regardless if they check for labor market success, educational quality, diversity, etc., we're always in. I see some people still standing. If you move a little bit and don't leave any open places, everybody can be seated. So if there's some place left, please do so. So the Financial Times, we think that's a very important one. Normally they will put us within the first top 10 places. So we are a top 10 European business school. And actually, Financial Times is an important one because it indirectly checks on quality, because you can only be included in the ranking of the Financial Times when you are accredited by ASCSB, by EQUIS or by AMBA, or if you're a member of the SEMS consortium. So it's a limited group that's eligible for this accreditation. A third indicator, well, there's a saying among business schools that goes, tell me who your partners are and I'll tell you who you are. It's very informative to check the partner list of schools that you're interested in. Is it okay? Is it good? Or is it excellent? Is it first year or even Ivy League? You're most welcome to check our network, and I'll show you some of our exchange partners later on. But we think we have a pretty good network. These three indicators give a clear picture if it's a top school or not. And you will find out it's the same group of schools that is internationally accredited, that is in the rankings, that cooperates with each other. As said, this international thing is very important for us. We made an additional step. We went for a special distinction with the Dutch-Flemish Accreditation Organization. We are the only bachelor program in the Netherlands with the qualification excellent in the field of internationalization. So what are we talking about when we're talking international business demonstration? These are just definitions that you could use. We focus on the management of international companies, and then I need to show you the next slide. Wherever you go for a business program, they will roughly teach you the same. If you check the course program, you'll see there's always a course in finance, there's always accounting, there's always marketing, there's always human resources. These are what we call functional areas in business. Every business school will teach you them. They're important because it's pretty likely that at a certain moment you will specialize in one of these functional areas, and it's also pretty likely that your first job will be in one of these specialized areas. So you will start as a marketeer or an investment banker, not immediately, but probably afterwards. So they're important, these functional areas. At the same time, we have more ambitions as a school. After all, we are a top school, so we're kind of preparing the CEOs of the future. In the end, we expect you to be a manager, that you're able to make a link between these functional areas, that you know, well, if I want to properly run a company, I need to take into account that, of course, I know I will be selling more products if I invest a lot of money in marketing, but I also need to keep an eye on my profits, and it should be doable. Are we able to produce the amount of goods or services that our clients want to purchase? It's important to see all these links. And this is where strategy comes in. And for instance, when you're in a company and you're thinking about your future, about your business plan, it's important that you also take the strategic perspective into consideration. So that's why we put strategy in the middle. Let's go back again to the definition, the second part. We try to prepare you for a career in international business by immersing you in an international study environment. Well, it's a nice sentence. We can imagine that, let's say, in 10 or 15 year times, you find yourself somewhere in the United Arab Emirates and you're cooperating on a project which needs to be successfully finished under time pressure. And you're cooperating with the locals, people from there, but also with the Chinese, they will be there. Probably some Europeans, probably also some Americans. And you need to be successful in the project. You need to be able to cooperate with each other, although you need to talk a foreign language, and although you need to deal with different habits. It's different when you're cooperating with someone from Germany, and when you give him feedback and say, well, your work is crap. Okay, the German says, I'll improve. Never tell this to a Chinese employee. It's different. So these are things that you need to get used to. This is exactly what we do, what we practice in the program. We have a lot of group work in the IBA program. You will find yourself in highly diverse groups, working with people who have a different background, different habits, different ways of saying things, different perception of time. Everything will be there. This is exactly what we do, what we train in the program. So we immerse you in an international environment to prepare you for an international career. Few words about other dimensions of the program. We are European, so that's a three-year program. We cover all these areas. We've chosen a broad approach, so there's no specialization in the program at this moment, although we may change this within a couple of years. So you get a little bit of everything, a couple of courses in finance, a couple of courses in marketing. So it's a broad program, qualifying you for any continuation for a master's or for a first job. We teach in English. We're very active on exchanges, internships. We are an academic program. We do certainly also have some more applied parts of the program, and I'll show you later on. Nice to see. We think this is our true capital, our asset. This is where the nationalities of the students we started with this year, so the group of 2016-2017. Actually, we took in students with 60 different nationalities this year, which makes us one of the most international programs of Europe and probably of the world. Not every country is there, but a lot. And it changes a little bit from year to year. We have some larger groups, so normally we refer to the big four, so to say, which is the Dutch, that's the largest group we have, followed by the Germans, the French, and the Italians, they're coming. And then we have smaller numbers of other nationalities. Well, you can see from Oceania, we didn't have anyone this year, so there's work to do in this part of the world. But we have this diversity in the house. What does it look like, our program? We work in trimesters, so there's 10 weeks of classes, lectures, workshops, preparation, etc. Then there's 3 weeks off for preparing your exams and taking your final exams. The most important message is down there. It says, well, that's the main difference between secondary school and university education. Number of hours in class, around 15. Numbers of hours of self-study, 25. That's opposite to what you're used to, because you may be used to be 30 hours in class per week. You may say, oh, that looks pretty relaxed, 15 hours of class, but the majority of the work needs to be done outside class. You're supposed to work on projects, on assignments, etc., sometimes individually, sometimes with other students, so you need to make arrangements, find a place to work on this. Full workload is roughly 40 hours a week, also because you need to study literature. But that's the main difference. So what kind of courses do we have in the house? Well, if you've noticed about dysfunctional areas, you'll not be surprised to see a course in finance and accounting. There's already operations management, so the production processes in companies. There's some supporting courses. But a couple of them are nice to highlight, and probably students who are in the program can do this better than I can. So I'm looking for a student who can elaborate a little bit on this first year course. Can you shortly introduce yourself?
Yes. Good morning, everybody. I'm Roberta, and I'm Italian. Actually, I'm half Italian and half Serbian, and I've lived in four different countries around the globe until I was 19. And I came here to IBA, and I found so many other people just like me with such an international background, same ambition, and open mind. And today, I would like to share with you a little bit more of what I liked of my first year. And now I'm in my second year. Especially, I would like to talk about two main courses, the Mentor Program and the Strategic Business Plan, which were my favorite. In the Mentor Program, we were in a small group with other students, and our teacher was a second-year student that was guiding us around Rotterdam, around the social life, around the exam, that was telling us the main tips about everything here in Rotterdam. And that was very helpful for me, not only to meet fellow students, but also to actually get around this new city, which I hadn't visited before. Another course, which was actually my favorite, was the Strategic Business Plan. And this is a two-trimester course in which, with a group, we're guided to come up and write a business plan, so a new strategy for a company. So together with my three closest friends, with whom I had the best nights out, but also that are very hardworking and one of the people that I still work with every time, we had to go find a company, so build a network since the first year of IBA. We went there, we asked for information, even the more sensitive ones, like financials, that were hard to get. We came back, analyzed them, wrote four assignments and a whole business plan. And then, actually, this course is a competition, and we won it. So that's also why I really liked it. But yes, those are the two main highlights of my first year regarding academics. But that's not all what university is all about. But for that, I'd like you to ask any questions later on to me and the other fellow students that are going to be at the panel downstairs. Well, for now, I'll leave the floor to Mr. Meijdam, and thank you.
I have one question for you left.
Yes.
Because you were only a first-year student when you went to the company. Did they take you seriously, or were they just laughing at you?
They did take us seriously, and they actually implemented some of the strategy that we advised them. So that was also very rewardful, because your work is paid off to see it become a real thing in a company at 19 years old.
And did you really give them a strategic advice? You should do this or this or this? Or
Yeah. Step by step, time with a timeline, and when to achieve what, the little milestones. Yes.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Erasmus University is the only university in the Netherlands in which you are required to successfully pass your first year in just 1 year. And there's some leniency on this, so if you did very well, got a great, good grade point average, there may be some lenience on a course that you need to retake the other year. But in principle, you're required to pass all your courses, which is a rather strict thing. And we're the only university doing so. We found out that it worked. In the past, you were allowed to take slightly more time. You're only required to get 40 ECTS a year. When we changed the system, we found out that immediately in the first year of introduction, we already had a higher percentage of students passing the first year after 1 year than in the past we had after 2 years. How did we do that? Well, we didn't do it like this. So it's not all the time that it's 10 weeks us talking and you be in a lecture hall doing nothing, just listening. That's a recipe for disaster, so to say, because then you will fail your exam and will just start before the exams. So we make you work all the time. That's the system we have. So for all the courses we have, especially in the first year, we have introduced intermediate opportunities to already earn, to obtain part of your final credit. So for many courses, there's a midterm exam, which counts for 40 or 50% of your final grade. Or for mathematics, there's an assignment every week in which you can earn credit or a bonus point. There's regular assignments, which also count to your final grade. So sometimes this leads to complaints from students. They tell us, well, you make us work all the time. Then we answer, yes, that's what we want. Because we know if you work on a regular basis, you will be able to successfully pass this this first year. So we believe in this system. Second year, again, some of these functional areas popping up. For instance, you see marketing management, you see some other courses. Technology management is a nice one to mention, because in this course you need to cooperate with students who study sciences at the Technical University of Delft. So you're working together on a project, and I can tell you these students are different. They're definitely not business students, so it's a very special experience to work with them as well. Something that will meet that will happen to you also later on in your job, because you will meet the technicians and the scientists. Cross-cultural management, which is a rather key course in the program, making you familiar with what it takes when cultures really mix, when they come together, when they work on projects, etc. That's one of the central elements in our course. The nice thing about having successfully passed your first year is that you have a rich amount of options as from your second year. For instance, you have the chance to do a double degree with the School of Philosophy. You can apply for an honors program. And Erasmus University offers some broad honors programs, interdisciplinary, so they cover a broad field. We also have our own honors program, which is on innovation entrepreneurship. And you can even board a trip to Silicon Valley if you're selected for this program. But there's many more options. We have the Case Society, in which you can participate in case competitions with other schools. So there's a wealth of options when you've arrived in your second year. Third year, there's something changes. So far, the program has been pretty prescriptive. You need to attend all the courses. It's a fixed order. But in the third year, that's the first time there's something to choose from, apart from your groups. So you can choose to go on an exchange to one of our partner schools. But you can also choose to conduct an internship, or you can do a set of electives, which we call the minor. Having said so, we're introducing a new thing next year, which is called the sandwich year. And this kind of changes the picture, because now it says, well, you can do either an internship or an exchange or a minor. When we have introduced the sandwich year, you can do both a minor and an internship and an exchange. It will make your studies 1 year longer, but it's pretty sure it will pay off, because we know that employers highly appreciate people who did an internship, and not just a small, a limited one, but a longer one. We know that employers are very keen on students with relevant international experience, and we know that you kind of improve your skills, also personal skills, personal characteristics, when you stay abroad for a longer time. So it is also helpful when you want to get to a job. So it also helps to strengthen your profile. So it will pay off to take the sandwich year. We'll be introducing it next year. The end of the program, we are research-based, and if you can remember, every trimester at least has a course that is a bit research-based. So we have mathematics, statistics, marketing research, quantitative decision-making. It all comes together in the bachelor thesis, which is a research-driven product that you need to write under strict supervision in the group of three, the final thesis, and showing us that you're able to work to apply all the research methodology knowledge that you've gathered so far. As said, we're active in exchanges. These are the schools that we are currently cooperating with for an exchange. We're very proud to have some of the US top schools. If you would check the US rankings, you will see of the top 30 schools, we roughly have half or even more of that in our network. So we have the Wharton School of Pennsylvania, we have Michigan Ann Arbor, we have Virginia McIntyre. We have great schools in the network. They're very selective to get in if you're studying in America, but we can make them accessible for you when we send you there for an exchange. So that's great. At the same time, we also see that there's really a rush for our Asian partner schools. We've expanded, for instance, our number of partners in Hong Kong to 6, recently adding Hong Kong Baptist University. Same for Singapore, the 3 schools over there we've already partnered. Continuously increasing demand also for partner schools in mainland China, because, well, this is where it happens. So there's a lot of student movements to Asia. At the same time, also, the top schools in Europe are also still popular. We've made sure that we have the top schools in Europe in our partner network, so the Bocconi School in Italy, St. Gallen in Switzerland. So there's really a network that we're very proud of. As said, in 3 years you can be done, or in 4 years if you choose to take the option of a sandwich years. Well, then the choice is yours. You're welcome to continue with us for a master's or a master's somewhere else. You can also start a first job. We see that taking a gap year is increasingly popular. Last year, 20 to 25% of our students did so, but this may change when we introduce this sandwich year. You can start a job, which will also qualify you if you are interested to take an MBA, which is also a Master in Business Administration, but that's a program you can only enter when you have a sufficient amount of relevant working experience, at least 3 to 4 years in a management position. Then you can choose to do an MBA. What do we have in the house? As said, we offer a very broad bachelor program. By consequence, our master program is highly specialized. So if you are interested in marketing and you choose for a marketing master, it's marketing what you get. More than 50 out of 60 ECTS is entirely spent on marketing courses. That's the general rule. We have a couple of exceptions, some specialties, so to say. We've just launched the first round this year, an advanced finance master for the very bright and clever in finance. A special program taking a couple of months longer. You really need to get to have very high grades to get in. There's a master's program that is not open for students who did a bachelor in business or economics, which is called the master in management. So if you did a bachelor in engineering or religion or languages, etc., you can apply for that one. And there's one broad master program we have, which is the International Management SEMS program. SEMS, already mentioned, the consortium, a worldwide consortium, a bit of an elite network, because only one school per country can be a member. So the London School of Economics is the British member, RSM is the Dutch member, St. Gallen the Swiss member, etc. That's also a program that takes a broad approach, because it focuses again on the international dimension of the program. It includes foreign languages, compulsory exchange, compulsory international internship. That's a broad and international master's program. So the choice is yours. Where can you end up? Well, just a few examples. From our surveys, we know that at this moment the most popular sector to work is the consulting sector. So the Boston Consulting, McKinsey is taking in quite some former IBA students. Normally, that's what I need to say, it's very few students who immediately apply for a job after a bachelor. So most students choose to also continue with a master's. That may change when we have introduced the sandwich year, because then you will gain additional practical experience. So most of our students continue with a master's. Finance is second, used to be the biggest sector, but has now been surpassed by consulting, so you may end up in the City of London in the banking sector. So lots of things going on there at this moment around the Brexit. Marketing, communication, that's the third largest, and then we have smaller numbers of students in the other functional areas in business. So this is where you could end up. And to give you an impression, roughly speaking, labour market perspectives are still pretty good, which has to do with the fact that students graduating from a broad program from a school that has a good reputation in principle relatively easily find their way on the labor market. Well, we'll show you some logos of very popular places where our graduates go. You'll see there's quite some big names on the list. You will not be surprised to see Shell, Unilever, with their headquarters here in Rotterdam. But all of these do have in common that they are big players and they play in the international arena. So this might be the place where you end up. We have quite some facilities because we think this is an important thing for a business school. So we have a dedicated career service office who can help you not only in finding an internship but also in finding a job, training you, checking your CV, training you how to properly apply to have a good discussion with your future employer. So that's a service we have in the house. Then we come to application admission. The big news last year and also this year was is that we have changed as a program to a so-called numerus fixus program. One of the most important consequences is that the application deadline came forward, which means that applications for the academic year 2017 have already closed because that was the deadline of 15 January a month ago. So we're already talking about the intake for 2018. So I hope it's not many among you who are still thinking of starting IBA in 2017 and who have not applied yet, because then you're simply too late. I hope the majority is of the before last year, or if you've already applied for the program and that you're in the process. So, an early deadline. We do have selective admission. We have to, because there's quite some demand for the program. We figured out last year that we seem to be the most popular program of the Netherlands. So the total number of registered students in Studielink, which is the central registration system in the Netherlands, surpassed 2,800 by the end of April. Not all students continue their applications, so because you also need to upload some stuff to us in our own system. So it was slightly below 1,500. This year we even surpassed 1,500, although we had an earlier deadline, so we're very popular. So we can afford to be selective. We have to. As a first step, of course, you need to bring a diploma, which that makes you eligible. So, and if you go to the website and check our pages, you can see which kind of diplomas we take in. Some diplomas we see very often. So, for instance, the most frequent diploma we see is the International Baccalaureate. That's also the largest group in the house. Of course, the Dutch VWO diploma, the German Abitur, the French Baccalaureate, etc. So we are familiar with these. If we don't know, we check. If you go to the admissions pages, you will see detailed descriptions of around 60 diplomas, including more specific requirements. So it's all there. If you formally meet our requirements, then the selection procedure starts. Actually, we select on three criteria. First, on academic performance, on grades, what kind of grades did you get at school. Second, we check your CV, and we are particularly interested in the international dimension of yours. I'll come back to this later on. Third, we check your motivation. Why do you want to be in an international English taught program? So let's take a closer look. Grades. Our level playing field is created by the fact that we ask you to provide us with your school grades of the before last school year. So if you're in the Dutch system, your summer school report of 5 VWO. That's our comparison level. If you have more recent grades and they're in favor of you, you're welcome to send in, but don't miss the deadline. If you've already graduated from secondary school a year ago, you're free to send us your best results. But in principle, we check the before last year's school report. We have set a threshold. If you're in the Dutch system, it all starts with an average grade of 7. And you would also need a grade of 7 for mathematics. And you also would need a grade of 7 for English. And we have comparable requirements for a large range of international diplomas, for the Abitur, the Baccalaureate, the Maturita, etc. It's all there on the website. And for some very common ones, we've already presented them on the slide, so you may recognize a couple of others. But the detailed information, again, is on the website. Then, we're interested, except we're taking pride in the fact that we're taking in such a diversity of students, so we want to know to find out who is applying with us. So we want to know, what is your nationality, where do you come from, where are you born, where have you lived, what kind of international experience do you have, can you even prove that this international thing is with you, for instance, what kind of subject did you write your extended essay about when you were in the IB system, or what kind of subject did you choose when you wrote your profielwerkstuk in the Dutch situation. We just want to have a complete picture. To see if we're able to compose again this highly diverse classroom. Then third, your motivation. Why do you want to come to us? And this is, of course, an important question, especially for the applicants from the Netherlands we have, because actually we do have a great program in Dutch which is called Bedrijfskunde, Business Administration. You're most welcome to apply there. They have an open admission, so you should try to convince us why you want to be in this international English taught program. And that's why we asked you a couple of questions. The last thing we want, because we prepare you for an international career and we prepare you for cooperating with people who are different, with different backgrounds. So the last thing we want, if we take in students from different backgrounds, that they all stick together. The Dutchies with the Dutchies, the Germans with the Germans, the Chinese with the Chinese. This is not what we want. So if you plan to board with us and to stay with your landsmen, so to say, that's not what we're looking for. No, we're looking for the opposite. We're looking for students who are truly interested in meeting people who are different, willing to learn from this, willing to also bring something themselves, because you bring your own background, which is very helpful to know and to learn about when you're from another country. So the international students learn from the Dutch learn from the internationals. That's what we want to make sure, that this interaction happens. So that's why we're asking these motivation questions. So for instance, we check, have you ever worked with people who are different? And what did you learn from it? And what is the relevance if you apply to the IBA program? So sit down, think, have I ever been in such a situation in which I needed to work or cooperate with people who are different? Not necessarily international ones, but also people with different backgrounds. This is something we would like to check. And a similar question, have you ever stepped out of your comfort zone? Because boarding IBA is a kind of stepping out of your comfort zone, because you will be taught in a foreign language, you'll be surrounded with people not from your country, at least not the majority. So it will be different. And we want to know, do you have the kind of attitude, or probably already an experience, that you can kind of convince us that you're able to manage this? Third, very important, of course you will understand, because we want you to develop as a group, how do you actually plan to integrate with people who are different? What kind of things you are going to do to really meet the Chinese, the Brazilians, the Koreans? What are you going to do? So think about it, about ways how you could mix, how you could mingle with people who are different, and tell us. And then fourth, a broader program, explain us a little bit why you want to be in the international program. And do you have some proof, some evidence that shows, okay, I'm typically the right person that you should take for this program. So that's how the selection criteria are. The rest is admin, so to say, as we call it. Oh, that's one too far. Our formal capacity is 575. Actually, we hope to end up with 550 because we have also some unnotified cancellations. Early deadlines. In the Netherlands, you can only apply for two numerous fixes programs maximum. So if you're interested in Tilburg, Maastricht and us, you can only choose two of us because all three have a numerous fixes. Other business programs do have an open admission. You can apply to two more, so four in total. Consequence of numerous fixes, an early deadline, already said, January 15th. There's also a second stage in this process because you need to upload a couple of things to us, your grades, your diploma, proof of language knowledge, etc. This has to be done before a certain date. This year we worked with February 15th, but we may choose a bit of an earlier date next year. So check our website. We'll take a final decision on this in September. So check us around September what the deadline is for uploading your files with us. If you're on time in uploading your information, the paperwork, etc., you will be included in what we call a ranking, just a simple list. And we will make this ranking in this way. Oh, that's one too far again. The grades will count for 50%. So if you're just around the 7, you might get 1 point from us. If you're way above, you get more points. Then we have the CV, that counts for 25%. And roughly speaking, the more international you are, the more international background you have, the more points you will score on this one. And then again, for motivation questions, again, another 25%. The better your answers, the more convincing your answers are on these motivation questions, the higher we will score you. We'll simply count the scores, produce a ranking. This will determine your place in the ranking. We need to have finalized this every year, 14th of April, and StudyLink will inform you about your exact place on the ranking exactly on 15th of April. If you're within the first, let's say 575, you're certain of a place in the program. If you have a number below, you're not in, but I must say you're not yet in. Because we know in international programs we have large numbers of applicants, we give out large numbers of offers, but not everybody accepts the offer and not everybody shows up. Reasons, we are kind of competing with other schools worldwide, so people in Asia compare us with schools in Britain, other schools in the Netherlands, in the US, etc. Sometimes they make a late decision. For instance, last year we gave out around 750 offers, so telling students you're welcome to board the program, and we started with just 550 students, so we lost around 200 students, implying that if you have a ranking number somewhere between 575 and 700, pretty much chance that you still get in. If you drop out of the list, so if you cancel your place or if you do not accept, then the next one on the list shifts the place up. So this is a continuous procedure until the end of summer. This is the flow chart we've used this year. We changed it a little bit for next year, but just to give you an idea. So there's some decisive moments. So the moment not to miss is the application deadline in StudyLink, because that's one in concrete, as we say. If you're just 2 minutes too late, StudyLink is simply closed. So that's a very important one. You upload to us to be announced, the exact date, announcement around 15th of April, 2 weeks to accept your offer and to finalize the whole procedure somewhere in summer. It's all on the website, so you can check in detail. A few practical remarks. Our normal price, our normal tuition fee is around 9,000 euro. That will be the non-subsidized fee. However, if you are the nationality of one of the countries of the European Economic Association, so the European Union, Norway, Iceland, Liechtenstein, Switzerland, you have the same benefits as Dutch students because you have a highly subsidized tuition fee, which is around 2,000 euro. If you pay this high fee, you can be eligible for a scholarship. We do have quite some scholarships on merit, so on excellence, so when you bring very good school grades and you also write as a proper motivation why you want to have a scholarship, we can award you one. And normally the scholarship will cover the difference between the high non-European fee and the subsidized Dutch tuition fee. Accommodation, important, especially when you apply from abroad. We do have on-campus housing. We have some dorms. We're building a new one next to the campus. If you apply on time, you can be pretty sure of a place. It's well equipped. Everything is there, the fridge, internet, etc. But it comes at a price. They easily charge you 500, 550 euro. And it's definitely possible to live way cheaper in Rotterdam. I know many students who live in houses for 300, 400, 500. But we see, especially from international applicants, they choose for comfort, safety. They board one of the dorms in their first year. Then you need to move out anyway for the next group. And in the meantime, you find out the place where it's way cheaper to live. When you are non-European, you will need a visa. For now, I just stay with a message, never start it yourself. Let us start it. We'll save you a lot of time and effort. Then, we have a part in the presentation that my students are much more familiar with than I am. So I'm looking to the left again. Can you shortly introduce yourself?
Hello everyone. My name is Bas. I'm a Dutch second year IBA student, and I want to talk about the extracurricular activities at IBA. So first of all, I did a Spanish language course at the language center here at the Erasmus University. And I really liked it because all teachers come from Spain or from Mexico and speak it as a native language. So I really learned much about that because my teacher didn't speak any Dutch or English. So that was really hard, but really fun. The RSM also promotes you to learn a language, so they'll fund you. You get money back afterwards. So really try that out if you want to learn Russian, Chinese, or whatever. You can do it here. Secondly, I'm doing a double degree with tax law. That's a Dutch program, so that's only for Dutch. But during IBA, we touch upon many tax issues, and I want to learn more about that. So I discovered I wanted to do a double degree with tax law. And thirdly, my girlfriend, she's in a third year IBA, and so she did her exchange last year. She went to Asia, and I joined her for a trip through Asia. And we met so many international people, and that is just IBA. In the lecture room, there are all different cultures, and you learn about these cultures, you meet international people, and that is just like traveling. So I really like that. Some communities that I wanted to touch upon, for example, BNR Beurs. That's the investment society here in Rotterdam. So if you're into stock markets, investments, please sign up for that because it's really helpful. We got SR, student representative. If you want to work and improve courses, help professors with improving the curriculum, please join student representative. It's really fun. Some of the current students here around, they're a member of SR, so ask about that. And STAR, that's another one to mention. That's the biggest study associations in Europe. It's the study association of IBA and BA. They organize a study trip. This year they're going to go to Beijing and Shanghai. So if you want to organize something like this, you can join them. They also have marketing groups and finance groups. So if you want to gain experience in that, please join STAR. And Erasmus Sports, if you're into sports, rugby, football, martial arts, there will be a club for it. So please go to the website Erasmus Sports when you are accepted because it's really fun. What I'd like to advise you is, during the first week, it's called Eureka Week, all communities will be out there and present themselves to you. Sign up for at least one, so you gain experience in something beside IBA. You get to know more people, so it's really fun. So next slide, please. A tip from me to you, especially for people who never lived abroad, don't be afraid if you sign up and think, well, I'm not internationally oriented, because you are. For example, if you've traveled to another country, this is me in Vietnam, just talk about your experience there, the people you met, if you went to another culture, another continent. Show that in your CV or your motivation. I did, for example, an exchange during my high school for 1 week to Madrid, Colegio Tua Soria, that's the high school over there. Mentions things like this, and since you're probably in your fifth or fourth year, but not your final year, look out for opportunities like this. And lastly, I participated in a multi-United Nations program from my high school. You meet a lot of international people out there, so you can mention stuff like that as well. So go out there now and try to gain experience in the field of international things. And for questions, and if you want to meet us, please sign up for the IBA Student for a Day, so you can really see for yourself how a day at Erasmus looks. We also have monthly live stream sessions. You can ask questions live, so please join them. And if you have questions about admissions, please go to rsm.nl/contact-IBA. And most importantly, we have to talk to current students, so if you want to talk to us, please go to this link. You'll see a picture of us, you can see the nationality. Don't hesitate to ask questions. There's no such thing as a dumb question, so put your question there, and we'll be happy to answer it. So hopefully I'll see you guys around on campus, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Which brings this presentation to an end. It's almost time. I would like to draw your attention to the next rounds. We have a student panel in place, so four students from different backgrounds who can answer all your questions, so take your chance. If you are French and you want to know, well, what are my chances with the French baccalaureate? How do I fit in? Or are all these Dutch students so good in English as the former student we just saw? Don't hesitate, just ask your questions, because this is your big chance. We have also a session with the former IBA students who are currently in the labor market. So take your chance to learn more about us. Thank you so much for being with us, and have a nice day.